Welcome, everyone, to the Tethered Shipyards. I am Takeshi Yamato, the Yardmaster, joining our host, the Housecoat Gamer.
Yo.
Today, we are taking a look at the MC-80 Starcruiser, a Rebel Starship design that is basically the equivalent of Imperial Star Destroyers.
At least for the Rebel era, though I do consider these somewhat superior in quite a few ways. If only they were given the Imperial touch.
Right.
Originally, these were designed as civilian luxury liners. Every single one of them was built to, well, contract. As an example, not every single one of these ships was 100% the same. Only a basic frame was the same. There were always a few bubbles in different places.
Yeah.
And while these ships were modestly armed for their size, because unlike Star Trek, Star Wars is a, well, uncivilized hellhole.
Yeah.
They weren't exactly built as warships. It was only after the Mon Calamari actually entered the Rebel Alliance, and a few shipyards actually decided, you know what, let's give as many turbo lasers and heavy laser cannons as possible to this thing as we can, that these ships actually became more viable in combat. Though, obviously, they were outnumbered 50-1, at least.
Yeah.
So, the Rebels weren't exactly going to be going up against ISDs in direct combat with these things.
No.
However, they did have one advantage. They could actually shoot while they were running away.
Yeah, they had guns in all firing arcs.
Which is why I call this the superior design. If you can inflict damage upon your enemy while you're retreating from him, that's not a defeat. Which is why I personally believe that the Imperials should have taken this lesson to heart, and, for lack of a better term, copied it.
Yeah.
I mean, it would not be difficult.
Yeah.
But Imperials are dumb.
Yeah.
Regardless, these ships primarily served as starfighter carriers rather than full-on capital ships.
Yeah,
and,
because,
well, they weren't really capital ships. They were converted civilian ships. They have next to zero armor. They had to rely solely upon their ungodly number of redundant shield generators to the point where Imperial captains are just going, "Why won't your shields drop, damn it?"
Yeah.
Shields were more of the problem for these things than, you know, firepower.
Yeah.
Which turns out to be a bit of a Mon Calamari staple for every single one of their warships, with the sole exception of the massive bulk that is the Viscount.
Yeah.
Regardless, it's time to stat this bastard.
Yeah. Entered service date, just for narrative purposes, 5 BBY?
Eh, it works.
Alright. Standard spread point amount, 45, because a 45 equivalent of 2250s. And scale 8 starship, just like the scale 8 starship, just like the Star Destroyers. So I'd say, so that's 49 points. Let's see. I'd say probably, comms 9. Computers 8, sensors 8, Engines 8, structure 8, weapons 8 for a start. Bit more balanced, but as a starfighter carrier, it needs more comms equipment. Maybe drop computers and sensors down to 7 each to bring structure up to 10?
Well, this thing is more or less just a shield sponge. Hi, yep. Let's keep shooting at you. Why won't your shields go down? Go down, damn it. Okay, send in the TIE bombers.
Yeah.
Because if plasma's not going to do the job, bombs will.
Yeah.
That or just send in the Eclipse. Either or.
Yeah. So, comms 9, computer 7, engines 8, sensor 7, structure 10, weapons 8. I think that works.
Indeed it does.
Department-wise, I'm thinking point in command, point in security, point in engineering.
Makes sense.
And let's see. Talents. Probably advanced shields.
I wonder how many instances of that we can stick onto this thing.
Well, we can stack multiples, so probably at least 2.
Yeah, because this thing is a shield sponge. I mean, sure, it's not going to be dealing as much damage, and it wouldn't stand a chance in hell in a one-on-one fight with something like, say, an ISD-2. Yep. But it's just going to keep going, and going, and going, against anything up to and including its size.
Yep. 2 instances of extensive hangar bays again?
Probably like 3. This thing is a, fighter boat.
Okay, so 2 instances advanced shields, 3 instances extensive hangar bays, 1 instance of secondary reactors?
Most like. Now, if I seem a little bit frustrated, it's because these things are more or less just, well, the space equivalent of an auxiliary cruiser. For anyone who doesn't have the historical context, auxiliary cruisers are basically ocean liners with guns. This little concept was thought up of in the years leading up to World War I, and when it was put into practice, it was quickly discovered it was a stupid idea. Because lightly armored, consumed fuel like crazy, had almost zero armament, because all you could do was fit them with a couple of 3-inch guns.
Yep.
Even a freaking Corvette could sink one of those things with contemptuous ease.
Yep.
It was a dumb idea.
Yeah, speaking of weapons, the MC-80 has heavy turbo laser cannons and laser cannon.
Yeah, she's better at the whole anti-fighter defense thing than the ISD.
Yeah, maybe add point defense system as well.
Yeah, that's most likely the best idea. Though, of course, her primary weapon system is not the guns strapped to her, but her fighters. Meaning, in a way, this is more like the Japanese battleship Issei than the, I don't know, an auxiliary cruiser. Yeah. That was still a dumb idea, but
yeah. And we still have the standard special rules for warships. Hyperdrive FTL, and deflector screens. And descriptor traits, rebel starship, repurposed civilian vessel.
I put auxiliary cruiser in there, you know, just to voice my displeasure of the entire concept. It just doesn't work.
Auxiliary cruiser. I've put that in quote marks.
But I'll...
Tank.
Yeah.
Tank.
Shield tank.
Yeah, shield tank.
Why won't your shields go down, goddammit?
Yeah. And that is the MC-80.
Why won't it die? but yeah.
Yeah.
It may sound like I hate this thing. I hate how it's executed. It's not a true warship. It's just basically the RMS Mauritania with a couple of quick-firing 3-inch guns.
And a massive amount of hangar base or runways or whatever.
From a I may not be a naval architect, but just hearing that gives me something of an aneurysm. Because it just doesn't work. On the water.
Yeah.
In space, you have a little more leeway, because it's space.
Yeah.
But on the water?
Yeah.
I think I need to recover from the fact that I'm dealing with an auxiliary cruiser.
Yeah, we'll see you later, people.
Bye-bye.